Hello friends, welcome back to Styly Bread Kitchen. Friends, today's recipe is a special Indian chaat, that is pav bhaji. Basically pav bhaji is from Maharashtra, very popular in India and also well recognized recipe in the world. So let's check out how to prepare at home. Here I'm using unsalted a medium cube size of butter. So you can add as much you like to add. So the entire recipe goes with the butter more. Once the butter is melted, you can add one large onion finely chopped. Cook it for 1 to 2 minutes in a medium flame. So once the onions are fried enough, we're gonna add tablespoon of chili powder, pinch of turmeric, tablespoon of pav bhaji masala powder, and also 2 green chili chopped, 2 tomatoes roughly cut, and also potatoes 2 medium which are cooked peeled, some fresh green peas, salt. So friends, again, so let this list of ingredients like a potatoes, tomatoes, green peas should cook in the butter. Just try, keep it stir fry for 1 to 2 minutes so that the butter taste adds more when it is mixed with the potatoes, tomatoes, green peas. The taste becomes really outstanding. So once 2 to 3 minutes of frying is done, we gonna add 2 cups of water. So mix again. So let this gravy cook in a high flame for 10 to 15 minutes. So close the lid, let it cook for 10 to 15 minutes. So friends, pav bhaji is really delighted recipe. Most of us would love to eat. This is the best one of the Indian chaat. So once pav bhaji, this gravy is cooked, so we gonna smash it very finely now. So while smashing, please reduce the flame. Smash it very finely. So smashing like this, it gives really more taste, especially the potatoes when combined together with the green peas, tomatoes will be very tasty. So once the smashing is done, add fresh chopped capsicum, some fresh coriander leaf, pinch of methi dry herbs, again unsalted butter. So friends, when you are using salted butter, you can adjust the salt adding additionally. So let this gravy cook for another 2 to 3 minutes. So friends, here if you think that gravy is too much thick, you can add some water, adjust the gravy and also the salt. If you think that gravy is watery, you can dry it up for 1 to 2 minutes cooking. So the gravy will be ready as per your taste. So once the gravy is done, squeeze the lemon off, give it a once more mix in a low flame. Then the gravy will be completely ready, very yum. Keep it aside. So now let's go and prepare bread. It is also called pav. So this kind of bread everywhere available in the supermarket. So place little butter. You can increase the butter quantity to roast the bread. So flip it each side for the butter coating, so that when we are eating this bread or pav with the masala gravy, it will be very delicious. And it has its own taste, and sure you will love it. So once the pav is done, remove it. So friends, now let's serve the way we love to eat the pav bhaji. I have placed bread and also I'm serving the gravy. Then lemon to squeeze and enjoy the recipe, and also some fresh green herbs, that is like a coriander leaf, just sprinkle it. So friends, pav bhaji without onions, it is incomplete. So of course, let's add some freshly cut onions to enjoy the pav bhaji. So our pav bhaji is ready. Meanwhile, let's check out today's motivation. No one is perfect, that's why pencils have eraser. So focus on how to erase and how to rewrite them. So friends, our delicious, tasty Indian chaat pav bhaji is ready. I hope you will like the recipe and also the motivation words. Thank you so much for your great support. See you again. Bye-bye.